Some kids love to eat broccoli, while others can't stand it.
I like that green stuff. I want it.
You want the broccoli?
How much do our genes determine what we like to eat? Can they turn otherwise good kids into picky eaters? If so, is there any way to help them? Bob Margolski of the Monell Chemical Senses Center and colleague John Glendening of Barnard College are trying to find out with the assistance of a few mice.
Why are mice useful to you at all? Do they have the same tongue as we do?
Well, it's much smaller. The physiology of the mouse's taste system is similar to ours in many respects.
In fact, when they gave this mouse bitter-tasting water, here's what he did.
Okay, he's right there. He's just licked it.
Oh, and he clearly didn't like it. And he's wiping his face off, and he squeaked.
And he got as far away as he could.
He hid in the corner.
And he doesn't appear to have any interest in consuming it ever again.
Ever again.
But Bob has devised a way to change how a mouse perceives taste.
We've genetically engineered mice that are missing key genes in the taste cells.
Look what happens when this genetically engineered mouse approaches the same bitter water.
He's just drinking.
He really can't tell the difference between this bitter-containing water, sugar-sweet-containing water, or just plain water.
So to him, it's just water.
It's just New York tap water.
Researchers are trying to find out more about how this gene works so they can find a way to temporarily turn it off. This could lead to new ways to block the bitter taste of medicine, especially ones made for kids. And that could make it a whole lot easier to swallow.
For children who won't eat their vegetables, can you foresee a day where we just give them a pill? It'll suppress the bitter sensations in their palate, and then they'll just eat the broccoli and the greens.
I think this is possible. You can imagine kind of like a salt shaker, except it would be an anti-bitter shaker. You take a plate of greens or a plate of broccoli, put this stuff on it.
It would be like a table condiment.
Exactly.
Any green vegetable is a combination of amino acids and salts and sweet carbohydrate and bitter. So the picky eater that's very sensitive to the bitter will reject it and reject all that positive food stuff because of the bitter taste.
Oh, so if you suppress just the bitter
sensories, the bitter,
then the rest of those flavors rise up.
And will be appealing.
There you go.